In a stat dating back to the 2018-19 season, the German Bundesliga has the highest average attendance among all football leagues. The German league averaged at a staggering 40,000 plus fans attending the league games. This speaks volumes about the football culture in Germany. German clubs across divisions have always enjoyed good fanfare, irrespective of their performances. While the league is heavily dominated by Bayern, fans who support other clubs regularly show up at games. The 50+1 rule plays a very important role in this culture. Today at Soccerspective, we explain to you the much hailed, criticized and at times confused clause of German football that is keeping the German fans at the center stage of the game. When the Berlin Wall came crashing down and the reunification of Germany took place in 1990, the East German clubs joined the Bundesliga in the West. While the coming together of football was not poetic in any sense, as only two East German clubs were allowed in the top flight and the rest sent packing to the second and third tier, it kick-started the need to bring in new rules for the German clubs to be able to compete in Europe. Before 1998, all German clubs were non-profit organizations owned by member associations comprising of fans. This changed in 1998 when the German FA or DFB allowed the clubs to switch to private or public ownership as long as the fans owned 50% plus one share of the club, putting them in majority ownership. This is where the clause originated and has stuck around. For a club to be eligible to compete in the Bundesliga, it has to follow the 50+1 rule. The 50+1 rule has effectively put the fans of Bundesliga clubs at the center of football in the country. The rule ensures that fans have the power to control their club. This has kept the likes of American billionaires, Russian oligarchs, and oil-rich states out of taking over the clubs and football in general. This doesn't mean that the rule has exempted foreign investment altogether. Gazprom, formerly owned by Chelsea owner Roman Abramovich, has pumped millions into Schalke over the years. But the story would have been very different if the 50+1 rule was not in place. The fans have the right to veto almost everything, ranging from a rise in ticket prices, changing club colours or the club crest, to refusing an ownership change. More importantly, it's not hard to become a voting member of these club associations. For example, you can become a Bayern member by spending just 60 euros annually. The fans getting to control their club is important, with what foreign investors did to the likes of Cardiff City and Valencia. This clause in the DFB regulations played a very important role in keeping the German clubs out of the European Super League discussions. In something that can be termed as a win for German football, both Bayern and Dortmund kept out of the discussions and later condemned the league. Despite the three founder club slots available, not one German club made the move to become a part of the league. This is a very good example of the football culture in Germany, where it's more of a fun and leisure activity over a money fest to earn the most. The 50+1 rule has been hailed by Europe for its contribution in keeping the Germans out and effectively helping in disbanding the project. The 50+1 rule is a necessity for the clubs to compete in the Bundesliga, but there are exceptions. The same clause that implements the rule also gives an owner the right to take over controlling stake of the club if they have been investing money for more than 20 years. Bayer Leverkusen, owned by Bayer Corporation, and Wolfsburg, owned by Volkswagen, are two such examples. Both these clubs were founded by the employees working for these companies. When talking about club ownership in the Bundesliga, it's hard to ignore Dietmar Hopp and Hoffenheim. Hopp has somewhat bankrolled his boyhood club from the 3rd division to the Bundesliga over the years. Hoffenheim have finished as high as 3rd in the league recently, owning 96% of the club. After getting a nod for the takeover from DFB, Hopp is a hated figure among Bundesliga fans. Then there's the RB Leipzig story. Red Bull faced fan protests when they tried to take over one of St. Pauli, 1816 München or Fortuna Düsseldorf. Yes, they could have sparked a Munich rivalry like no other with 1816 München, but Red Bull settled for SSV Markenstadt in Leipzig. The club was rebranded as RB Leipzig and played its first season in 2009-10, reaching the Champions League quarter-final in a little more than a decade from amateur football. But German fans don't like this, as they have already displayed with Hop. In Leipzig's initial Bundesliga season, they had just 7 members with voting powers. All of them were Red Bull employees. The members have grown since then, but have to pay a hefty amount compared to other Bundesliga clubs. The club has also earned itself a loyal fan base in Leipzig, which was deprived of top-flight football for a long time. But Leipzig's ownership and shady membership model has made it the most hated club in Germany. This also raises the question, how effective is DFB in stopping something like this in the future? Bundesliga is not the most competitive league, and nor is it the most stable one. Bayern not only dominate the league, the Munich club plays a massive role in weakening the Bundesliga sides as well. Bayern is known to poach players away from other Bundesliga teams. The general trend in Germany is that other clubs are just a stepping stone to either go on and play for a big club in other leagues or play for Bayern. The likes of Manuel Neuer, Lewandowski, Leroy Sané and numerous other players at Bayern have come through other clubs in Germany. Most, if not all, German clubs are always in a cycle of selling and rebuilding their squads. This has made the league very volatile. A club can finish in the European places this season and fight for relegation the very next. The 50+1 rule blocks many, if not all, foreign investors from helping these clubs out, and a naturally rich Bayern gets to boss the league. The 50+1 rule has kept German clubs away from the money-minded cycle being carried out in other leagues. No one in Germany will want to see a Manchester City or PSG-like club in the Bundesliga. But the rule is equally responsible in making these clubs helpless at the European stage, where only Bayern is capable of reaching the pinnacle, and the rest have more or less become feeder clubs for the rest of Europe. What are your thoughts about the 50+1 rule's impact in German football? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to like and share this video and subscribe to Soccerspective for more such content. Thank you for watching.